So you want to start running, huh? Nice. Keep up that enthusiasm. You're really going to need it. So it's no surprise that running as a sport is already mainstream and is getting even more famous very, very quickly. And that's for good reason. It's really accessible. It's very, very cheap. You burn calories like a crazy person and get very fit doing so. There's no barrier to entry in this sport. All you need is a comfortable pair of clothes and a pair of shoes and you're good to go. There are, however, some things you should keep in mind to make your entry into the sport, your journey and your experience a little bit better. Now, full disclaimer, your first few runs are going to suck. This sport by no means is an easy one. And that's especially true if you're on the heavier side. You know, if you're overweight, if you're really tall and broad, or if you're just really muscular, if you're just overweight, this sport can really put a beating on your body. Keeping all that in mind, there are a couple of tips I can give you to make this sport and getting into the sport that much better. So let's get right into it. These are my 5 tips on how to start running for a beginner. Now, firstly and most importantly, take it easy. If you're a complete beginner or if you've already run a couple of times, you need to really take it easy. Now, depending on your fitness level, you have to decide your distance for the first few runs. If you're already relatively fit, I would say cap it off at a maximum of 4 kilometers. Otherwise, 2 or 3 kilometers is plenty to begin with. Also, intensity. When you're running, you should be able to speak in short sentences. In case you're struggling to remove more than 1 or 2 words out of your mouth, you're running too fast. Now, for some, this may even mean starting off just by brisk walking, and that's fine. Do that. Stick to it. As long as you stick to it, you will improve. Now, once you get comfortable with this, start increasing your distance slowly and steadily and forget about the speed. Now, everyone falls into a trap of wanting to go faster, but believe me, distance is key. Your speed is just going to follow. Now, a secondary point to this is that run, walk, run is going to be your best friend. A simple example of this is you start running 500 meters, take a 200 meter break of walking, and then again run 500 meters. If you keep doing this, eventually that 500 meters is going to become 5 kilometers, and that 200 meters is going to become 100 meters. This tip is especially helpful for the heavier runners since your joints are taking more beating than the average Sharma on the road. And there is nothing wrong with doing this. Even people who've been running for years do this. Now for the second point, food. As you start running, your food habits are going to need some changes. The first thing you're going to have to do is increase your protein consumption. If you want to know exactly how much protein you need, click here. I'm waiting. Click. Now, running is a high impact exercise. And while being a high impact exercise, you burn calories like a mad person. This means that your body is taking damage and you're going to need the food to repair that. Initially, when you start running, you're going to feel a lot more hungrier than usual, and that's completely normal. Now, I'll just touch upon this. If your goal is weight loss, you're going to have to push that goal for at least 2 or 3 weeks, since when you just start running, you're going to need extra food to repair your body. After this initial stage, you can easily go back into a calorie deficit and lose your weight. Now, what about eating before your runs? This is going to be an experiment since everyone's different and everyone will react in a different way. But a good rule of thumb is to be relatively empty stomach when you go for a run. However, you may want to eat some fast absorbing carbs. Parle G, some glucose biscuit, bananas, potatoes, all this comes under fast absorbing carbs. Have a little bit of that 15-20 minutes before your run and you should be good to go. As you run more and more, you'll figure out what works for you and what doesn't. Third, toilet. Yeah, I know no one wants to speak about it, but someone's gonna do it. So you have to ensure a good bowel movement before your run. I'll make it really short and simple. When you go for a run, your bowels get really smooth and go into overdrive. And if you haven't done your morning business beforehand, you are going to want to do it really badly as you're running. And depending on where and what time you run at, you're not going to have access to a toilet easily. So always, without fail, ensure a good morning routine. Otherwise, you're going to have to do a very uncomfortable walk of shame while you're on the run. Now, fourth, recovery. As I said in the previous points, running is a high impact activity and your body's gonna take a beating. The heavier you are, the more load on your muscles and your joints, and the smarter you have to be about your recovery. Regardless, give yourself enough rest. You don't have to run every single day. 2 to 4 times a week is more than enough when you begin. And on the other days, either take complete rest or just go for a nice easy walk. Secondly, your protein requirements need to be met. I cannot stress that enough. And the most important point of recovery, your sleep. Make sure that's on point. Another thing you can try doing to aid recovery is to run on softer surfaces, places like beaches, running tracks, or whatever you have access to. This point is especially important for the heavier runners out there, since this is a very good place for you all to start running before hitting the roads. Fifth, and a point no one likes, warm up and cool down. Okay, I know no one wants to do it, I don't myself, but it's really important, really, really important. Imagine your muscles to be like rubber. Only when rubber is warm enough can it actually stretch and be elastic the way it's supposed to be. Your muscles need to be warm just like that. A quick 5-minute warm-up will also be enough. Similarly, a quick cool down, some stretches here and there, is equally as important. Doing this now will reduce your recovery time later and help you get better results. So please, as much as you don't want to do it, please do a short warm-up and a cool down. And now, a bonus point! Now, the best thing about running is how cheap it is. The most expensive thing you can buy when you get into running is a GPS watch. Let's talk about that. So the thing is that your GPS watch provides you with only one benefit over your phone. Convenience. That's all. The only exception being heart rate, which is very cheap to solve. Buying a heart rate chest strap won't only give you more accurate results, but it's relatively cheap to buy. And since we all just carry our phones anyways when we go for a run, this is not a smart investment. Yes, unless you don't want to carry a phone or you've been running for a while and you want some more advanced stats, this still makes sense. Otherwise, it's just not worth it. Instead, what I would suggest is buy a better pair of shoes and some good earphones. They not only will actually help you improve your results, but will make your running journey a lot more enjoyable. And that's about all you need to know when you start running. Keep it easy, eat enough, take a dump, recover and stretch. As long as you follow these points, your entry into the sport is going to be a lot more smoother and less painful than it would have been. Do this for a couple of weeks and wait for my follow-up video. What? The best point is yet to be said. You know how you can find out what the point is? By clicking that red subscribe button you see down there. Go on, click it, there's a bell icon also. Click that. And as always, if you have any questions, feel free to ask me and I'll see you around.